Hello guys, I'm Sri. Today I'm going to explain about the different types of MySQL variables configuration methods. Okay, so variables means there are a lot of variables in the MySQL for the MySQL configuration purpose or the MySQL tuning purpose. Related to this, we have a lot of variables. Okay, so you can list all the variables using the show variables command. Let me execute. I have one MySQL installed in the server already. The version is MySQL version is 8.0.26, the latest one. If you execute the show variables command, it will display all the parameters available in the MySQL. Okay, so currently totally 645 variables. Okay. So let me explain what are the different ways available to configure the MySQL variables. Okay, so the first one is session and the second one global and expresses. Expresses is the latest one. It is available in the MySQL 8 only, and my.cnf you can use the option file, and also you can configure the parameters in the command line as well. Okay, so the first one is session, right? So let me explain how to do that. So before that, what is session variable means? It will impact only the session, your current session. The other sessions, for example, there are a lot of members connected to your database, right? So whatever you are doing in the session variable, that will impact only your session. It will not impact the other sessions. Let me show the example. So for example, current timeout, okay. Let me show global variables. Like wait timeout. Okay, so the current wait timeout configuration is 28800. Okay, now I just want to set the wait timeout session with the lower number. Okay, for only my session. So in this case, set session wait timeout equal to some number 100. I'm making it 100. Okay, so I am able to set the wait timeout in the session level. So if I check show variables like wait timeout, it will display 100. Okay, because I said in the session level, I set it to 100. But instead of show variables, if I give show global variables like wait timeout, it will display the original threshold. It is 28800. Okay, so here this is the difference between show variables and show global variables. Show variables means it will display the current value in your session value. It will display the session value. But if you give the show global variables, it will display the parameter. Okay, so let's see. For the example, in this session, I set wait timeout equal to 100. Now I am going to create one more session for this MySQL. SSH MySQL one. I'm trying to log in the same server only. Okay, this is the same server only. If I give the show variable command in the different session, here it will print the original value, 28800. Okay, because I only set this in this session only. It will impact only this session. It will not affect the other sessions. Okay, so this is the way how to set the session value. Okay, so you might have one question. So all the variables you can do the session, right? But all the variables don't have the session scope. For some variables only you have the session scope. Okay, so to know what are the variables you have the session scope, for example, right now is at the wait timeout, right? So let me find the wait timeout here. So this is the wait timeout. Here you can see the scope. For all the variables, you can check the scope in the MySQL official documentation. Okay, so for my wait timeout variable, the scope is global and the session. So I can set this variable in the global and the session. So those variables have the session scope. You can set it on the session. If the variable don't have the session scope, then you cannot set it on the session. Okay. So this is about the session variable. There are some use cases, like if you want to disable the, you are doing some insert or update, you are doing some modification. If you don't want to go those changes in the MySQL bin log, then you can set the session value. You can, in your session, you can disable the bin log, right? Like set SQL log bin equal to zero. Okay, so I just given the set SQL log bin equal to zero. So in this case, what will happen? Whatever you are doing, insert or delete or update, whatever, those statements will not return in the binary log. Okay, if you want to hide some statements to the binary log, bin log, then you can do the, you can disable the bin log in the session log. Like this, you have many use cases. If you want to do in session level, you can use this variable. Okay, so this is the way you can set the variable in the session and how it is working. Okay, the next one is global. Okay, so for this session, you use the set session. Right, the syntax is set session. For the global, set global. So what it will do, it will impact all the session. So whatever you are changing in the global, it will impact all the server level, it will impact. But whenever the MySQL restart happened, it will be rolled back to the default value. Okay, so let me show the example. I'm just reconnecting. For example, max connection. Okay, show global variables like max connections. So the current value is 151. I'm just changing it to show set global max connections equal to 100. I'm just changing it to 100. Okay, I'm just reconnecting the session. So now if I check here, show global variables like it is 100. If I am creating the, I am checking in the other session. Okay, this is the other session. Here also, if I am checking show global variables like max connection, it is 100. Okay, so if I, for all the sessions, it will be impact. If you say, if you are doing the changes using the set global, it will affect all the sessions. It is a server level impact. But if you are restarting the server, the old changes will be rolled back. I mean, currently the max connection is 100, right? Let me restart the MySQL here. Service MySQL D restart. I'm just restarting the MySQL service. Yes, it is restarted. If I am checking the value again, it is rolled back to old one, 151. Okay, so that is the change will be impact the server level. It will impact all the sessions if you are giving the set global. But whenever the MySQL restart, MySQL service restart happen, the settings will be rolled back to the default value. Okay, so this is the global thing. So you should make sure that whenever you are enabling the value, when you are changing the value using the set global, you should also make the entry in your MySQL configuration file. So in that case, if you are restarting your MySQL service, it will get the value from the my.cnf and it will apply during the startup. Okay. The next one is set persist. So to overcome the set global, I would say to overcome this set global, we have the set persist. It is a overcome. Okay. So what set persist will do, whenever you are doing the set persist, let me explain. So set persist first. Okay, so here you have two options. In the set persist, you have two options. One is set persist and another one is set persist only. Okay, you have two options in the persist. So what set persist will do, it will do the modification on the runtime, and also it will write the variable change in the physically in the file. You have the dedicated file, it will write in the file as well. So whenever MySQL restart happen, it will get the changes from that file and it will apply the value. Okay, but what set persist only will do, it will not apply in the runtime, but it will write in the file. Okay, it might be confusing. Let me show the example for. Okay, so here the show, the current max connection value is 151, right? Now I am going to change 151 to 100 using the set persist. Okay, set persist. Set persist max connection equal to 100. Okay, I did set persist max connection equal to 100. Now let me see the current max connection value. It is 100. Okay, so whenever I set updated using the set persist, it was set globally max connection equal to 100. Again, if you go to our data directory, MySQL data directory, it is varlib MySQL. There is one file created, mysqld-auto.cnf. Okay, if you view this file, here you can see max connection value is 100. Okay, there is a JSON file. If you see set max connection, the value is 100. And it was done by the user root and localhost. Just ignore this right now. So this is the main thing. So whenever I am doing the modification using the set persist, it will do the change on runtime, and also it will write the changes in the physical file. The file name is mysqld-auto.cnf. So what is the purpose of this? Whenever the MySQL restart happens, it will get the value from this mysqld-auto.cnf, and it will load during the startup. Okay, so that is called as a set persist. It will do the modification on the runtime, and also it will store the changes in the mysqld-auto.cnf, right? Now, again, instead of set persist, so here my current max connection value is 100. Okay, 100. Now, what I'm going to do, instead of set persist, I'm going to do set persist only. Only max connection equal to 50. Okay, now what I'm doing, I am changing the max connection value from 100 to 50, but I am using set persist underscore only. I am using set persist only. Okay, a max connection equal to 50. So I did. Now let me reconnect, and now let me check the current value. Show global variables like max connection. It is still 100. Okay. I set it to 50, but the variable is not changed. It is 100. Why the variable is not changed? Because I use the persist underscore only. So what persist only means, it will not load the do the runtime change, but instead of do the runtime change, it will do the modification in the file. See here, max connection value is 50 now. Before it was 100, but now 50. So whenever the restart happens, whenever the MySQL restart happens, it will get the value from the mysqld-auto.cnf and it will apply it. Okay. So this is the difference between persist and persist only. Persist will do the changes on runtime and it will write in the file. But persist only will only write the file. It will not do the runtime change. Okay. Now let me show, let me restart the MySQL. Service MySQLD restart. I'm just restarting the MySQL. Okay. Let me show the max connection variable. So the global variables like max connection. Now the max connection value is 50 because it took the variable from mysqld.cnf. Okay, so hope this is clear. Now, if I want to, you have the table under the performance schema. under the performance schema, show tables like, I think persisted. Let me, yeah. So you have the table persisted variables. Okay. So select start from persisted variables means, what are the variables you did changed with the persisted, set persist command. Those variables will be listed under the persisted underscore variable table. This is for the tracking purpose. If you want to check what are the variables are in the persist, then you can visit this table and you can get to know the variables and values. Okay. And here one question. So currently MySQL D. So currently this one variable, mass connection is there, right? So if you, how to do that? If you want to reset some variable, how to do that? So for that, you have the command set reset persist. If you give the reset persist with the enter, then it will reset all the persisted variable. Okay. If you want to do the reset for specific variables, then you need to mention the variable reset persist mass connection. It is reset. Now if I checking this table persisted variable, now it is empty. And if I am checking this mysql.auto.cnf, it is also removed from the mysql.cnf. So this is the way you can handle the persist and persist only. Okay. And the next one is my.cnf. So mostly my.cnf, you need to restart for some variables. For example, show global variables like, let me go to some InnoDB variables, InnoDB. So for example, InnoDB write IO threads. I just want to change this InnoDB write IO threads to 2. Okay, set global, I'm using the set global. InnoDB write IO threads equal to 2. Okay, so when I'm trying to change on the global, it is telling that this is a read-only variable, which means you cannot set it on the runtime. You need the MySQL restart for this kind of variables. Okay, so for how to know these things, here you have the in the MySQL official documentation under the variable, you have the dynamic section. Okay, if the dynamic is yes, then you can do the runtime change. But if the dynamic is no, then here the dynamic is no, right? So in this case, you cannot do the do it on set using the set global. You need the MySQL restart. Okay. So for my case, I'm just trying to change the InnoDB write IO threads equal to 2, but this is giving the error. It is a read only variable, so I cannot do it on a runtime. So how I can do this? I need to edit my.cnf. Okay. So here I need to place that InnoDB write IO threads equal to 2. I'm just saving this file. Then I need to restart my MySQL. Service MySQL D restart. See the current value, it is 4. I'm just trying to change it to 2. Okay, MySQL is restarted. Now again, I am checking that variable. See, now the InnoDB write IO threads is changed to 2. Okay. So this is the way you can do it on the my.cnf. I mean, this needs the MySQL restart. You cannot load the configuration file. You should restart your MySQL service. Okay. So far the session one is, it will only impact your session. And the global one means it will impact all the session. It is server level change, but whenever the MySQL restart happens, the changes will be rolled back. Okay, it will go to the default one. Okay, and default one or whatever values you have in the my.cnf, it will take that. And the persist one is, you got two. One is set persist and set persist only. What set persist will do, it will do the global change and it will write in the MySQL d auto.cnf. And what set persist only will do, it will not do the global change, but it will write in the MySQL d auto.cnf. So whenever the MySQL restart happens, the value will be picked up in the from that CNF, MySQL d.cnf. Okay, so then we see the MIDAR CNF file. So for some variables, you don't have the dynamic scope. So for those variables, you need the MySQL restart. So you need to enable the value in the MIDAR CNF and you need to restart the MySQL service. Okay, so these are the things so far we covered. And here, one more thing I want to share. If I am using this set, I mean, in the right authors, I changed to 2, right? I'm just using 2 set persist. Set versus, you know, db write time authors equal to 4. I am changing it to 4. It will also not work. Okay, global and set versus are same. The scope is same. It will also not work. But here, if I am using set versus only, it will work. Okay, the changes is not happened because set versus only, what will do? It will not do the runtime change. So this change is not happened. If you see this variable, show global variables, like the change is not up, it is not changed to 4, but the changes will be written in the auto.cnf. okay, see, you know, db write I authors value is 4. So whenever the restart happens, it will be picked up during the startup. So for this kind of variables, you can use the set persist, but the changes will not happen immediately, but whenever the restart happens, it will be picked up. Okay. Then the final one is command line. So command line means like, service MySQL is stop. I'm stopping the MySQL service. So whenever you are triggering the MySQL D service, MySQL D start, it will invoke the MySQL D. Okay. So you can manually start the MySQL using the MySQL D command, right? So if I want to change some variables, like let me show the example once again. So here, show global variables like, you know, db log file size. Okay. So the default is 48 MB. This is in bytes. You can convert it to the 1024. Okay. So current value is 48 MB. Okay. This will display in the bytes. So the InnoDB log file size value is 48 MB. I want to change it to 96 MB during the startup. Right. So what is the easy method? You can edit the MIDAR CNF. And here you can edit InnoDB log file size equal to 96 MB. Then it will pick. Okay, from the MIDAR CNF. But you can also do in this way. I'm just stopping the MySQL. Service MySQL is stop. Okay, it is stop. So whenever you are invoking the service MySQL is start, it will invoke the MySQL D script. Okay, so you can also manually do that. MySQL D hyphen hyphen InnoDB log file size equal to 96 MB, and you need to mention the user MySQL, user equal to MySQL. I'm just wanted to running in the background, so for that I'm using the ampersand symbol. Okay, so what I'm doing, I'm just starting the MySQL service manually using the command line. In the command line, I'm starting the MySQL service using the MySQL D. I am just changing this variable, you know, db log file size equal to 96 MB. And MySQL should run in the MySQL user. So I mentioned the user equal to MySQL. I want to run this command in background. So I mentioned the ampersand symbol. Okay. So now let me start it. I just started. If you see, the MySQL D process is running, right? MySQL D process is running and InnoDB log file size is 96 MB, I said. Let's see. Okay. Show global variables like InnoDB log file log file underscore size. Okay, now this is this much of bytes. I'm converting the bytes to the MP 1024 1024. See, it is 96M. Okay, so this is also one of the way you can do, or you can change the variable. Okay. So, but mostly people are not doing this, but I just wanted to explain. So you can also do in this method. Okay. So these are the different types of how you could do that. And also you have some other types also. You can mention the variables in the, inside the query. For the query level, you can change some variables, but that is fine. So these are the main things. Five important methods you should aware how to change the variable. And here the persist one, this persist one is introduced in the MySQL 8. If you are using the lower version, like MySQL 5.7 or 5.5, 5.6, whatever, you will not have this option, set persist option. Okay. Yeah. So I think I try to cover all the things related to this. If you have any questions, just comment. Whenever I have time, I will take a look at it. If you like this video, just give like and share with your friends and subscribe my channel. Okay, bye. Thank you.